today we're going to talk about Open Service Mesh. My name is Michelle Norley. I'm a software engineer at Microsoft. I contribute to and work on open source cloud native technologies. A service mesh is a dedicated layer of infrastructure for managing and securing service-to-service communication. OSM is an open source, Envoy-based, SMI-compliant, and Kubernetes-native service mesh. Let's break that down just a little bit more. With OSM, a Sidecar Envoy proxy is injected into each application pod. The proxy then manages all incoming and outgoing traffic. A control plane, which is a set of OSM components running in Kubernetes, manages this set of Envoy proxies, which we'll refer to as the data plane. If you're not already familiar, SMI stands for Service Mesh Interface, which is a set of portable APIs for configuring the most common service mesh capabilities. Key features of OSM. You can use OSM to configure traffic shifting for common deployment scenarios, secure service-to-service communication with automatic MTLS, enforce fine-grained access control policies for your services, observe metrics for debugging and monitoring of your services, integrate with native or external certificate management solutions, and you can onboard applications onto the mesh with our automatic Sidecar Injection feature. The following is a set of demos to help you get started and set up with using OSM. First, we'll see how to install OSM, thus setting up a control plane. Then we'll set up our applications and our data plane. Then we'll define some access control policies. And then we'll see how we can do traffic shifting. Let's take a look at how to install Open Service Mesh into your Kubernetes cluster. The first step is to download the OSM CLI binary. Once you have that set up, run the OSM install command to install an Open Service Mesh control plane. The control plane is the brains of the service mesh, as it's the piece that bootstraps and manages the data plane, that is, the set of Envoy proxies running inside application pods as sidecars. The control plane has several other features we'll get into later in the demo. You can have multiple control planes in a given cluster. Each control plane will be installed into a specific namespace and just needs a unique identifier we call mesh name. These can be configured with flags on the command line, or you can use the defaults provided. The install command will first perform a set of checks to ensure that your cluster is ready for installation and that you have the necessary permissions for a successful install. It will then install the OSM control plane components as Kubernetes resources into the specified namespace. The bulk of the logic of OSM's control plane lives in the OSM controller pod, as you can see here. The other pods are used for observability features. Now that we have our control plane installed, let's go ahead and get our data plane set up, so our Sidecar Envoy proxies. OSM allows you to enable automatic Sidecar injection on namespaces, and we're going to walk through how to do that. First, let me show you what I have set up so far. So I have these applications set up already, and notice that they have one container running in each pod. So I have a bookstore application. I have version 1 and version 2 of a bookstore. I have a book buyer that talks to the bookstore and basically requests to buy books. I have a book thief that tries to steal books from the bookstore, so it's also talking to the bookstore. And I have a book warehouse, so whenever the bookstore loses inventory, it'll restock by talking to the book warehouse application. Now, to add these namespaces for automatic sidecar injection, all I need to do is add a label on the namespace. But I'm a little bit lazy and I don't want to do that, so I'm going to use the OSM namespace add command. And I'm just going to add all of the namespaces where my applications are currently running. Now, the way this works is that every time a pod gets started in this namespace, OSM is just going to inject the Envoy proxy as a sidecar into those pods. But in order for us to be able to do that in a situation where we already have pods running is where we're going to need to just like restart the pod. So I'm going to use the kubectl rollout restart command to do that. And I'm just going to restart each of these applications. Bear with me as I do it for these five applications running. And if you haven't already seen this command, it's pretty handy. The last one will be Book Warehouse. All right, now let's go ahead and check out what's going on in our application setup here. So as you can see, these pods have just been restarted and they now have two containers running in them. So let's just go ahead and see what the book buyer pod looks like to get an example of what actually happened. So I'm going to describe this pod. And as you can see here, if you go up to containers, you'll see two containers are running, the book buyer container, which is your application, and the Envoy proxy container. So just like that, it's pretty simple to get automatic sidecar injection. So we currently have an OSM control plane running, and some applications have been added to the mesh and configured with sidecar proxies. Let's take a look now at how we can implement access control between these services. OSM has native SMI support, so you can use traffic target and traffic specs SMI resources to get granular about which services can talk to each other, on which routes, and even match on HTTP headers. By default, if you add an application to the mesh, no other services will be able to communicate with it, unless allowed. Communication is deny all by default. As you can see by the current state of our applications, no books are being bought by the book buyer, no books are being sold by the bookstore, and no books are being stolen by the book thief. To actually enable services to communicate with each other, you need to deploy SMI traffic target and traffic specs resources. And on the right, you'll see what a traffic target for the bookstore actually looks like. So here we're saying that the book buyer can talk to the bookstore on some specific route group configurations. And below down here, you can actually see what that configuration looks like. And here you can get very granular about what paths you allow, what methods, and even headers. So let's go ahead and apply this configuration and see what happens. All right, so we're gonna wait a few seconds for this to kind of all propagate and traffic to start flowing. And during that time, let me talk to you about permissive mode on OSM. So if you're new to Service Mesh, you may not be in a place where you want to enable this deny all by default service communication configuration. You may actually want all your services to be able to communicate with each other at first. And for that, we have a flag called enable permissive traffic policy on the install command. So take a look at that if you want to just kind of observe your traffic patterns at first before actually applying any access control policies. All right, so coming back here, we can see now that we've added this access control policy, that books are being bought, and the bookstore is selling books because we've actually enabled it with our configuration. Down here, if we wanted to actually allow the book thief to talk with the bookstore, we would just go ahead and change the configuration like I just did there, and then we would just apply the manifest. So that has been configured. And so in just a few seconds, we should see the book thief being able to buy books from the bookstore or steal books from the bookstore. In this situation, we're actually just assuming the book thief has changed its ways and promised not to steal books and will actually buy books instead of stealing them. And here we see that books are coming in, that books are being stolen by the book thief from the bookstore. Let's take a look at how you might do traffic splitting with OSM for rolling out different versions of your applications. You can use the SMI traffic split resource to define what your traffic split should look like. Currently, we're routing all of our traffic to bookstore B1 and none of our traffic to bookstore B2. If I were carrying out a canary deployment, I'd want to maybe start out with rerouting 10% of my traffic to V2 and leaving 90% at V1. After observing some metrics around how that traffic is doing, I'd probably decide whether I want to increment more of my traffic to V2 or not. I can also automate this process with progressive delivery tools on top of the mesh if I want to be less manual about the whole thing. For this example though, we're going to route 50% of our traffic to V1 and 50% of our traffic to V2, and then we're going to go ahead and apply this configuration. All right, so that's going to take a minute to kind of like reconfigure. Let's go ahead and reset these counters so we can get a better idea of how the traffic looks right now. And while we're waiting for those changes to propagate, you can also do A/B testing scenarios with traffic split, as SMI now supports matching on HTTP headers, even on the traffic split resource. All right, so now we can see that the counters are incrementing and roughly half of the traffic is going to be one and half of the traffic is going to be two. That concludes our set of demos. In this section, we set up the control plane and the data plane. We installed applications into our service mesh. We also defined access control policies and saw how we could configure traffic shifting. Here are some resources that you can use to learn more about OSM. Thank you so much for joining us today.